The very second that these individuals, whoever you might be dealing with, senses or knows that you're moving on, that very second, that's when they're gonna come gunning for you. And I mean gunning for you. The second they feel that oh shit moment, he's really gone, she's really gone, they're coming. They're coming gunning. This makes people want you badly, because they know how much you don't give a solitary fuck. They can feel it. They know you literally don't care at all. You're good, but they're not. And it's strange, because at one point you might have cared. But the second you stop caring, she starts chasing. The second you stop caring, she starts chasing. Guys, this is crazy. The power literally just went out in my spot. It's 2 a.m. right now. There must be a power outage here or something tonight. Let me see if I can hook something up. Like another light in the back or something, but you guys can still see me. Let's see if we can get this going. This is the first time this ever happened, ever, on my channel. That sucks. But yeah. The second you stop caring, that's when everybody wants to be a part of your life. Forget about a relationship partner. Forget about her. Forget about that guy that now wants you. It could be your friends. When you were in trouble, when you were going through a hard time, you just weren't fully up. You were a little bit shaken up. Things happened. The second you're real good again, better than ever, and they know you're living life and oh my God, look at him without me. That's when they want you badly. Nobody gives a flying about you at all until you're living it up. And when you're living it up, that's when they're all gonna start to care. Because you're now living a better life than them. They wanted nothing to do with you. They didn't want to talk to you at one point. No more. They wanted to ignore you out of their own benefit. They wanted to do all that. Until now you're up. Now that you're up, they want you back. Now that you're up, they're gonna come on real strong. They're gonna come at you. They're gonna message you. They're gonna try to get a hold of you. They're gonna try to get things from you. They're gonna try to get answers from you. They're gonna try to do whatever they can do. Whatever they can do, they're gonna try to get your attention, to make you focus on them. Hey, it's me. Hi. And they're gonna come waving at you. This is what they do. I'm right here. Now that you're living it up, living better than them, you have a better attitude than them, you're just doing better than them. All around. In a better mental space, in a better mental state. Healthier, stronger, fitter, more attractive, more wealthier, more healthier, more everything. You have it all. That's when they're going to come back. That's when they want you more than anything is at that very second. And what decision, this is the question, what decision are you going to make in this case? Are you just going to give it to them? Are you just going to hand it over? Are you just going to, yeah, let them all trade in and you're just going to easily be their friend again or easily take this bitch back or anything? Are you just easily going to just do all that? You guys can make your own decisions, but if you want my advice on this, you already know. All I'm going to say is, don't make it easy for nobody. Do they make it easy for you? Did they make it easy for you? No, they did not. In fact, they betrayed you. In fact, they've done the opposite of make it easy for you. They've done the opposite of make you feel welcomed. They've done the opposite. So, I say, turn down most of these individuals. And if you really aren't quite certain if you want to give someone a shot or not, don't make it easy for them. Let time go out. Let time go out. Let time go out. Let time go out. Really, really, really make them work for it. Really make them work for it, because they're not deserving of you so fast. They want things so quick. They want to come to you so quick. They think you should just bend over backwards for them. Why? Because it's them, they'll say. It's me. It's your friend. They're going to act like your friend. They're going to act like you were friends the whole time. You know that's not true. You know what happened, but they don't want to talk about that. They don't even want that to be the narrative, but that's what happened. People will leave you out to dry, bro, until it's convenient for them. People will leave you for death. If you were to die, life would have went on. Nothing would have mattered. Now that you're up living a good life, people see it. They want to run towards that now. They want you now. Because you're the Mr. Hotshot now. They want you now. But they didn't then. You might have went from Mr. Hotshot to going through hard times because shit happens in life. To then Mr. Hotshot again. And you, during these seasons, you are going to get to see the true colors in people during these seasons. That's what you're going to get to see. I still can't believe this damn power went out, bro. It's a power outage. Like, my power's not out because of a storm. It's a power outage. The whole city, the power's out 100%. Because it's 2 a.m. on the button. For fuck's sakes. I still had shit to do that needed power tonight. But yeah, man, for God's sakes, what are we ever going to do with these individuals, bro? Not take it easy on them. Make them work like a dog for anything, because they don't deserve you just like that. They don't. Who they are, who you are, all the shit you had to go through. People aren't earning. People aren't worthy of that. All you've worked for, they think they can come just right in, bro. If you even let that happen, they are going to destroy the value you have created. And I don't want to make this about genders, I really don't, but man, women are literally magnificent at doing that. they don't understand how hard, like a lot of them don't understand how hard a man has to work to earn his place, to earn his value. They really don't. They have no problem coming in, still acting like she's superior to you or some shit, ruining your value, doing crazy shit, acting like you're not the man when you are the fucking man. Like, and they extract so much value from you, bro. They extract so much value from you. They will come in, see everything you have got going on. They'll take as much as they can take from you, and they'll dip. You know what that does? That completely ruins your value. It ruins your worth. They take so much. That's why you can't make it easy for nobody. You set the tone. You set the standard for any friends, for any women. If you're a woman, for any man that comes into your life, you set the tone. You set the standard. And if you're a woman, I don't mean you lead the way, but you set a standard. You have conversations with that man. You have important conversations with that man. You set boundaries. You set things in stone. Vice versa. You don't just let people come in to do what they want, to have it their way with you. That's not how shit goes. It's going to be very cordial. It's going to be you and a person, bro. But most people is just trying to possess you in this life that we're living today. They're trying to come in to make it what they want it to be, what they imagine life to be, and they want to go their way with you. And I say no. It's me and it's you. We're going to talk, we're going to discuss things, and we're going to plan things out if things are going to work to begin with. That's how it has to be. It's how it has to be. Because a lot of people in today's day and age are fucking delusional, bruh. Some people even think they're doing the right things when they come into your life at first. You might give some chick a shot. She might actually think she's down for it until her mind changes because she didn't know what was going on in the first place. She just thought she did. A lot of these women, bro, they be thinking they know and then they don't. And then shit gets bad, shit gets ruined. Things get out of hand. They make things seem like something that is not, like, all the time. All the time. And it's from their own thoughts and delusions of what they're thinking. That's why conversation is so important. You'll speak out of your mouth. Back and forth. We set shit straight. We're not thinking of what things should be like and... Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. I just thought of it in my delusional fucking head. That's what it is for sure. Yeah, that's what it is for sure. So, get the fuck out of here with that. That's what, bro. It's embarrassing. Like, are you kidding me? Like, are you actually kidding me? This is how a lot of women are today, bro. They don't want to talk. They really don't. They don't want to hear the truth. In other words, they don't want to hear the truth. They just want it to be their way and what they think and all this shit. That's what it is. Same with your delusional friends. They just want it to be what they think and... They don't want to have conversations, bro. They don't want to have real conversations and do real things, bro. Most people don't want to do real shit today. They don't. They just want things to be what they think. And why do you think so many marriages and everything else is failing? Because people get into things without really discussing things. They loved the idea of it. You loved it. You loved the idea of it until shit hit the fan. Because those uncomfortable conversations did not happen. And to me, it's not uncomfortable at all. It's uncomfortable for your delusional asses, not me. It gives me comfort having uncomfortable conversations. Having conversations like this on my channel all the time gives me comfort, gives me more peace to speak your mind. We can't, bro, I can't talk the way I talk in this channel to just anybody out there. Most people could not, literally not sit down and just hear me talk. They're going to get right uncomfortable and oh my God, demons flailing. They had to get out of the damn place. Real shit. Real shit. They don't want to hear it. They want to live in their fantasy in their head of what they think things are and stuff without being in the thick of things. I love it. I love to be in the thick of things. I'll debate. I will conversate with anyone who has a brain on anything. You know what I hate? Having to be silenced. Having to be in the same home as somebody else. And you have to tiptoe on eggshells around people. You can't speak your mind. You can't say things as they are because someone's going to freak out at you. Oh my God, you said this. Shut up. You don't want to hear it like it is. You don't. And you're manipulative. You're cunning. You're evil. And you're manipulative. And you want everything to be the way you think it should be and all this little bullshit instead of just being in the face of a real conversation. This is what I can't stand. This is why having your peace today is the most important thing you'll ever have. Because that's where everything starts. But without your peace, you have nothing. Because you're going to be controlled opposition by some delusional headcase clown. And it's going to gup your life. Some of you are trapped with toxic parents in a house. Some of you are trapped with certain individuals. You're with a relationship partner. You don't even want to be with them, but you're with them because you can't fend for yourself. You are in over your head, my friend. You have to make it the number one goal and priority to get yourself out of that situation. Make it the number one goal and priority. Because your life has not even started until you can reach square one, where you're away from everyone, when you can think clearly, when you can think straight, and nobody around you is making you walk on eggshells. Nobody around you is trying to like mold you into what they want you to be that best suits them. Roll them up into their suit, tie them up, throw them into a briefcase, and fuck them. You have a life to live. Instead of being around ultra delusional people who never want to hear the truth. They just want things to, it's their imagination, it's what they want things to be and all this bullshit. That's how things get ruined. You can't lead life like that. You can't. You have to be very vocal with people to be on the same page. If you're not on the same page, if you can't have uncomfortable conversations, say goodbye to any relationship, friendship, family, ship you have, say goodbye. You're not going to be close to the person. People wonder why I'm not close with them today. You are the one that don't want to be close. It ain't me. You're not even a person. You're not even a person that can conversate. It ain't me. It's you, not me. Because people don't want to actually talk. What's the weather like today? Who gives a? The weather is what the weather is. You happy? Are you fucking happy with yourself, mate? It is what it is. We can't change it. Why talk about it? It is what it is. Deal with it. Deal with the weather today. Deal with the weather today. Who cares? Let's talk about something that makes sense. But no, too much. Too real, that's the problem. And these people whine and bitch and moan and complain that we're not close with them. We're not close enough. We don't spend enough time together. I don't even want to look at you. Because you're not even a person. You don't really want to talk. These conversations, bro, make these people shed tears. Oh, they don't want to hear it. But this is the shit I live for. And they don't want to hear it. And I don't want to hear their shit. That's why. It's a match made in hell, not heaven. We're not meant to be. I go my way, you go yours. Have fun in your delusional world. I'm going to kick ass with this one life I have. And with that being said, God willing, God bless. I'll see y'all at the top. And actually, the last thing. Just be very careful, bro. Just be very careful of who you let around you. Of who you let back into your life. Because even these delusional people, bro, when they see us doing very, very well, they're going to have this sense of urgency to try to come back. And bro, I'm telling you, if you let these people back, if you let these people back in, bad mistake. Terrible mistake. Do not do it. You should be able to see clearly enough that you probably should not do something like that. You should be able to see clearly enough. No, things are going good. And guess what? Last time I was engaged with you, last time I was with you, things were very bad. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. I ain't looking for something outside of myself. I ain't hard up or desperate for something outside of myself. I'm going to keep climbing because I'm on a roll right now. And guess what? If you stop climbing and you try to take everybody else up with you, they're going to pull you right back down. So you ruined everything. Don't take them back.